Angry Baltimoreans gathered outside Davidge Hall in 1831. They accused students and administrators of desecrating fresh graves and dragging bodies out of local cemeteries. Those inside the building knew the claims were true. The medical school hired professional body snatchers to obtain cadavers for anatomy classes. A professor of surgery complained about the mobs, disgusted that the school's regular body snatcher was
greatly alarmed and feared for his own personal safety and was not able to procure me a sufficient number of subjects for my demonstration.
Mobs like the one in 1831 may have delayed professors' ability to procure bodies, but grave robbers continued to dig up bodies of the poor from places like the Potter's Field, Church's Hospital Cemetery, and even Westminster Burial Ground. During the Civil War, the practice became unnecessary. Bodies of unknown soldiers filled cities across the United States. Sometimes Davidge Hall administrators packed bodies into whiskey barrels, selling them to other medical schools like Harvard and Dartmouth. One Davidge Hall alumnus boasted,
"The great abundance of dissecting material is constantly claimed among the advantage offered by this city."
After the Civil War, medical schools once again resorted to body snatching. Baltimore's poor especially feared the dissection of their loved ones by medical students. Their fear skyrocketed after the 1886 murder of a local African-American woman named Emily Brown. Two men, one a janitor at Davidge Hall, killed her and sold her body to the medical school for $15. H.L. Mencken recalled the terror of his West Baltimore neighbors after the murder, writing,
"Only the bravest or craziest ever ventured to pass the medical school after dark."
Eventually, body snatching spread into Baltimore's more upscale cemeteries. Forced to act, members of the State Board of Anatomy changed cadaver practices. The Anatomy Act of 1890 forbade grave robbery as a method for obtaining cadavers. Medical schools could acquire bodies left unclaimed for more than 2 days. Despite the act, fear of body snatching still lingered in communities near the medical school for decades.